In this short video, we will discuss technical analysis as it relates to pattern recognition. We will first define technical analysis and then move on to discussing pattern recognition. We will then touch on a number of patterns, which include continuation patterns, such as triangles, and then reversal patterns, which include the head and shoulders pattern. The study of technical analysis is based on the idea that all the current market information is already incorporated into the current price of a financial instrument. With this in mind, the best way to determine future price movements is to study past price action to determine the potential future price movements. Technical analysis can be broken down into a number of categories. Some of those categories include support and resistance levels, trend lines, along with patterns. While support and resistance, along with trend lines, describe supply and demand of price action, patterns tell a story which can be recognized from past scenarios. Patterns use historical price action recognition to forecast the potential future movements of specific markets. Analysts use historical prices, which generally reflect potential continuations or reversals, which give clues about the potential movements of future price action. Triangles reflect price action that is consolidating and poised to break out. During a triangle pattern, prices generally move within a well-defined range, making lower highs and higher lows as the triangle is formed. This represents a triangle as the market is making higher highs and lower lows, poised potentially to break out to the upside. The price action reflects positioning by traders as they wait for an impetus for future price movements. As price action continues to consolidate, market participants attempt to find equilibrium, which forms a pinpoint of a triangle. While the market is forming this triangle, volume begins to dip as the tug-of-war between bulls and bears rages on. The symmetrical triangle is a continuation pattern, which means that the resolution to the pattern is a breakout to the upside or downside and a continuation of a trend. Another type of triangle pattern is the ascending triangle, which resembles the symmetrical triangle. The ascending triangle is a consolidation pattern that generates higher lows, but not necessarily lower highs, as the market moves in a relatively tight range looking for an impetus for direction. The top end of the triangle is level, as new highs are met with resistance, but the bottom of the triangle is upward sloping with higher lows. Demand for the market continues to make its presence constantly pressing resistance until a breakout occurs. The market breakout coincides with higher volume as the market climbs. Another type of triangle pattern is the descending triangle, which resembles the ascending triangle but slightly reverse. This pattern is considered bearish and it is observable after large downward moves in the financial market. The bottom portion of the descending triangle is flat while the top slides creates lower highs. During consolidation of this pattern, strong resistance creates downward sloping market action, which is resolved by a breakdown to lower levels. When the consolidation pattern ends and the market breaks out, is usually accompanied by increasing volume. One of the most recognizable patterns is the head and shoulder pattern. This pattern is considered a reversal pattern that is used by market technicians to determine a market top. A left shoulder is created as the market attempts to make new highs, but it is met by selling as a specific resistance level. When the market moves up initially, it is met by higher volume. But as the market begins to slide, making its first shoulder, volume then decreases. As the market dips during the uptrend, a new high is created as the market breaks out to the upside, but it is again met by resistance at the higher high, which forms the head of the pattern. Once again, when the market dips, it is repurchased at support levels, which starts to form the beginning of a consolidation. As demand reasserts itself, the market climbs, forming the right shoulder. Upside progression is met by resistance prior to making the new high, which creates the right shoulder. Selling pressures pushes the market back down to what is referred to as the neckline of the head and shoulder pattern, which is eventually broken, creating the reversal of an uptrend. Volume rises as the left shoulder is formed, but declines, forming the head pattern. The increases and decreases in volumes are key to determining a true reversal pattern. The inverted head and shoulder is the reverse of the head and shoulder pattern and represents a reversal of a downward trend, while the standard head and shoulder is a representation of a reversal of an uptrend. When analyzing patterns, investors should consider how volume affects each type of pattern. In general, the key to a successful pattern formation is to observe increasing volume as the market is breaking out and a resolution to that pattern. For example, when the head and shoulder pattern breaks down or up through the neckline, it should be accompanied by increasing volume. As the pattern is formed and consolidation occurs, volume should be declining.